Hello everyone. Today we are going to talk about the number one reason why people quit their jobs. My name is Neha Malhotra and I'm on a mission to help small and medium enterprises build a healthy work culture. Do you know studies have shown that 70 to 80% of the MBA graduates quit their first jobs in the first 12 months of graduating from the B schools? The studies have also shown that they quit their jobs not because of lack of technical skills, but because they are unable to fit into the company culture. Culture, a very interesting word. A lot of us keep talking about that the organizational culture should be good. A lot of us have heard the quote by Peter Drucker, "Culture eats strategy for breakfast." But how many of us actually understand what culture means? The best definition of culture that I have come across till date is, culture is a set of living relationships working towards a shared vision. It's not what you are, it's what you do. Now, what is a healthy culture? A healthy culture is considered to be the one where people feel safe, valued, comfortable, and they see growth opportunities for themselves. How to build a healthy work culture, especially in small organizations? So the healthy culture makes people feel safe, comfortable, valued, and it provides them growth opportunities. A lot of small and medium enterprise business owners think that why should we invest in our people if we know that they are going to leave our organization in the first few months? And I ask them, could it be that probably they see no value addition in their career profile while working with the organization and therefore they leave it? You may not be able to provide growth opportunities to your people. However, as a leader, it is your responsibility to provide them with the capability development opportunities. Now, here are four things I suggest business owners should do to build a healthy work culture. First and foremost, hire people not to just fill in the vacancy, but for their passion towards the work they do, and then show them how they can learn a lot in your organization. Number two, invest in their skill and personal development trainings on a regular basis. Number three, create a developmental plan for your people after they join you within the first 2 months, and let them go after 2 to 3 years of working with you if they find better growth opportunities elsewhere. They are only going to talk good about you if you have invested in them and they have learned in your organization. And this will help you build your employer branding. Last but not the least, it is easier to build safety, make people feel comfortable and valued in a smaller organization. So please do focus on these things.
Three things all successful organizations do to build a healthy work culture. Daniel Coyle, author of the book The Culture Code, has done research for 4 years with all successful groups from diverse backgrounds, and he found out three things in common with all these organizations. Number one, they build safety in their organizations. They make their people feel safe. Every employee who joins new has a few questions in his mind. Am I safe here? Will I be comfortable working over here? Do I have any future with these people? Number two, these groups encourage vulnerability. A lot of people think that vulnerability shows weakness of an individual. But look at it from a different perspective. When I go and share my fears and anxiety about the uncertainty of a circumstance or a situation, or I share a mistake that I've made in the past or right now, don't you think the other team member also would want to open it and share his fears and anxieties and the mistakes that he has made in the past? What would this do? This would help in building trust in the team members. And I'm sure everybody understands how important it is to have trust in a team for a high-performance team. Number three, all these successful groups share a purpose with their people. They share the vision of the organization. only when your employees understand that why are they coming to work every single day, what is the larger purpose of them doing the tasks that they are doing today, will they feel motivated enough to work every single day. If you like the video, please click on the like button, comment and share it with people who will get benefited from it. Till we meet again, thank you, bye-bye.